Today I'm going to talk about all the work that needs to be done for all of the vehicles in the fleet. Then I'll DD1 tune the amp in the Acura. Amplified is produced by Soundman Enterprises, Inc. and NVX. Buy genuine Soundman iPad dash kits at soundman.co and find high-quality car audio equipment at nvx.com. This baby's going back to U.S. Alternator. He's going to put these guts in a billet case, in a billet Subaru case, so it'll sit right here. Ooh! Look at it. Oh, this bolts on here. Never mind. Just kidding. It doesn't. No. I shaved these brackets. We'll paint these. We deleted the butterflies out of these units here. They have a TGV delete kit that I'd like to get that cleans up all this. So we can take this piece off and clean the motor up. This plastic piece is all broken. I want to just make this thing look clean and new. We'll put all new gaskets and shit on. We'll get those on there, we'll paint these brackets, get the alternator on. We'll need to modify the radiator or maybe just buy a new one. But it has a port that lines up to this. We need a top left and a bottom right radiator. We'll clean this piece up, paint the intake manifold. The motor cleanup will kind of be a side project. Now's the time to really clean up the engine bay. We could re-rhino line this. We need to finish some of this sheet metal. All this shit needs to be closed in. I would love to get the motor and the engine bay cleaned up while the transmission's getting fixed. And then eventually fix this roll pan. This is cracked all the way across. There's a crack here, and then this area isn't shaped right. So we'll have to get a new factory back piece and make a new roll pan somehow. That would be badass. Then we'll go whole hog on the interior after that, after it runs and it's all bitching. We could rewire some stuff, make some door panels. So we'll be doing that to that. Now over here to this, I'm sick of it. I'm sick of this thing. I think today I want to adjust the stereo with the DD1, make sure it's not going to clip. Then I want to put the box in and pull these ports through. This thing's pretty much done. I wanted to put a window on that amp and put some lights everywhere, but we'll do a little bit of that. We'll tone it down a notch. I still want to put that alarm in, which is going to take 4 years by itself. Put the voice module. But what this thing needs is some upholstery. So I'd like to drop these seats off and the steering wheel. I didn't fart. That was my butt squeaking on the thing. Someone's gonna leave a comment and say Doug farted at 4 minutes and 53 seconds. Okay, fucking embarrassing. I'd like to fix these seats, steering wheel. This thing needs floor mats. Would be cool. And this baby's done, baby. This baby's done. We need to buff out these headlights. And it needs like a side skirt. This side skirt's all fucking warped. Look what you did. We'll need little parts for this. It needs a dust shield. One of them is squeaking over here on something. This needs little shit. My son doesn't even have his license yet, so I'm done before him. I'm ready. He's not even done yet. He's not even ready. Are you done yet? This fine luxury machine will be waiting for him. Okay, now listen here. I'm not done. We have a lot of shit to do. Okay, look at this. See this fucking amp? See this long ass amp that Brad gave me so generously? What do you mean I have to pay for it? Look. So far I paid $1,000 on this baby. And I still owe But this needs to go in the F-150, and we're gonna chrome that W7 and put it in the bandpass box, as well as some other shit. I wanna do another nice round on the F-150 stereo, get this big Macintosh in there. We're gonna rebuild and chrome that W7, touch up the box, put a tonneau cover on it, and a carpet kit in the bed. We gotta touch up the dash panel. Maybe we'll put a new iPad Pro in it. I would like to significantly upgrade the highs with some ideas I have. I don't want to talk about them yet, but we'll get that big giant Macintosh 6-channel on the highs and a lot of power on the bass. But we'll talk about those ideas later. That's what we're going to do to this. Find legendary old school car audio gear at legendsofcaraudio.com. Upgrade your vehicle's charging system with a high output alternator from US Alternators. Visit usalternators.com. Now what we'd want to do is get this big Macintosh 2-channel out of here, put the Macintosh 6-channel in there, upgrade the highs significantly. We want to go SQ on the F-150, get that big ass amp out of there, because what we need to be doing in here, oh my, look at this. Look at this. What we need to do here is swap this little 2-channel with the big 2-channel. Our crossover networks are hidden back here. We'll just notch this out, use this whole area for the larger Macintosh 2-channel. The crossover networks can go in that quarter panel. We have our 1,000-watt bass amp in this one, so we don't have a speaker in that one. We could pop that panel off, make a cool little plate, put the Macintosh crossover networks in there. Then we'll have amp in here, networks in there, larger 2-channel so the highs will be louder. The bass on this thing sounds bitchin' with that 1,000-watt audio control amp on that Focal 13, the bass is fine. Then we could do some sound deadening on this, on the deck lid and shit, because this thing rattles a little bit. But what this also needs is some stiffer springs in the back and one step shorter cylinders all the way around. And this thing would ride a lot better in the back. We need a deeper spring cup, 1-ton pre-cut coils, and a shorter cylinder back here so that the cylinder locks up before the shock tops out. Then this thing will ride. That's what we need to do to this. Okay, now to this. Now with this fine vehicle, this needs to get parked in the Walmart parking lot and left there. See, what happened back here is that there's this ledge that water would sit on. So it kind of rusted this area, and this roll pan got smacked on the floor when it was getting unloaded off of a trailer. And whoosh. So like this factory piece just needs to be chopped out. You see how curved this is? It kind of flattens out right here. It probably warped when it was welded. And it's never gonna, it probably shrank. But this piece will never be right unless we just cut it out and fix it. This top edge is pretty clean, even though it's probably made out of Bondo. This has all been one grand scheme to pimp out my Volkswagen, Thunderbird, and F-150 with YouTube's money. I've had this plan for 20 years and it's finally coming to fruition. When I'm 60, I'm gonna have the sickest almost finished cars in the nursing home. I'm gonna get all the pussy. All on YouTube's dime. Literally, that's what I get paid per video. Look at this. What year is this? A 2017 Thunderbird. Is that what this is? Same wheelbase as that car right there. It's the same height. too. Look. Dang. Rafa painted his red car. Oh, this is a Manuel shifter. Oh, you got a helmet back there. Oh, you're wearing a helmet in this baby, huh?
Oh, that's probably why it's dying on me.
What happened?
I did some mods to it, so now I'm tuning it.
Oh, you fucked it up again. Did you tune the reverse gear out of it?
I have not tuned the reverse gear out of it, actually.
It must be nice. Let's street tune it. I'll drive.
Did you just say you would drive?
Yeah, let me grind them gears, boy. Who's your mama?
Who the fire's dad over there, dude?
Who's your daddy? So what we'll have to do... Now I'm going to use the DD1 to tune the amp in the Acura, then I'll attempt to test the tune of the fourth order bandpass box with the IMSG. Oh no, all the bolts rattled loose. Just kidding. We're gonna have to get this all the way out of the way. Get to getting. Okay, can we get back here? I can see the amplification unit. I'll have to disconnecticate one wire so we don't blow our subs. Then we'll put the DD1 on this. Now we can see here we're hooked up to the sub we were clipping. Look at that clippage. Right there is it. I didn't disconnect my highs from the amp when I adjusted the highs. You got to be careful if you do that because you don't want to blow your tweeters by playing a test tone for too long. So I just turned the gain up to see where the gain landed, and then I turned it back down. That should be it for the bass won't clip, and the highs won't clip.
Down for Sound is an authorized dealer and offers the best prices on the brands they carry with the fastest shipping in the industry. Go to downforsoundshop.com. Take your fabrication skills to the next level with the tools and trainings available from Mobile Solutions. Check upcoming training dates at mobilesolutions-usa.com/training.
That's adjusted so it won't clip. Now I want to see if I could test what that box is tuned at, because I suspect it's tuned low. But I want to see how this sounds real quick. I want to see how loud this is. It's my first night in the spot. I can't front people jumping in the spot. Those highs sound pretty horny. Now we'll hook up the subwoofer bass system. This is going to enhance the bass waves of the audio.
Not enhancing the bass waves, stupid.
Bitch, that's what a subwoofer bass system does.
Not the sound waves, though, bitch.
What does it do then?
The microwaves.
It microwaves?
Yeah.
All you can think about is food, bitch. All I can think about is your mom's flatbread. About to crack them loaves of flatbread, baby. Now we're gonna start the vehicle. Make sure our battery unit is not dead. It's not dead because I hooked the charger up. Like a smart guy. Now we're going to use this IMSG unit to find the tuning frequency of the subwoofer bass system. I've never tested a fourth order, so this will be interesting. Because on a sixth order, on a ported box, you find the two peaks, and then the dip between the peaks is your tuning frequency. On a sixth order, there's three peaks, so you're looking for the two dips. This is when we tested the F-150 box. So I'm assuming this will be similar to this, because technically this is still two boxes, a sealed chamber and a ported chamber. But I don't know if one chamber is sealed, I don't know if it works like that. It looks like there's only two peaks, so I don't know if this works. But if I tested like a ported box, it's tuned at 48.5. Maybe we'll hook up the RTA next.
This doesn't seem right. I don't think this is how you test the tune of a fourth order band pass. To me, it seems like the box is tuned a little bit too low. So next week, we'll take some test tones out to the car, drag the RTA out, and see the final results of the system according to the RTA. What if it looks like shit on the RTA and I ruin my perfect record? In front of millions of people, in front of hundreds of people.
Get the fuck on with it. We're gonna get this unit out of here. Removing unit! Come on out of here! Now we're trying not to get angry and break it. You see, there's a fruit fly in my dome light. Sucked it in my mouth.
What?
I sucked a fruit fly in my mouth. Bending back, flexing spinal column. Is this the side that comes out? Come on out. Oh no, my thumb. Testing dome light polarity.
6 hours later.
Oh yeah. All right, I'm gonna leave you in this trunk to see if this works.
After that DD1 tune, this turned out damn swell. Shit! Sounds pretty good for just one set of components, a cheap Pioneer deck that I practically stole from Best Buy because they price matched Amazon and I was one number off when I looked up the model number. My bad. And just one amp and two swap meet 10s from the 90s in a box that I guessed on. What if it looks like shit on the RTA?
It doesn't matter what you did, Doug. Now I can still remember when we first met each other. Exchange numbers, promise we won't forget each other.
Grab one of our rear view mirror hangers with the classic Soundman logo on it. Help support the next build. Thank you guys so much for your support. I'll see you guys next week. Purchase industry leading iPad dash kits from the originator at soundman.co. Your car deserves the best. Update your car with an iPad dash kit from soundman.co. Find high quality car audio gear at nvx.com. NVX is committed to audio quality and innovation. Their high-end car audio components are rated accurately, and they've been proven to perform since 2011. Try NVX at nvx.com.